There's a lot of excellent activities that can help kids. Everything from playing games that are grief games. We've turned Jenga into a grief game just by writing different feelings on all the Jenga blocks. And when you pull one out, you just say one time you felt that feeling or what can you do to get that feeling out. All kinds of activities as well for if a person is dying. Kids often don't know how to be with the person who's dying. So if they're resistant to visit the hospital or spend time in the room with mom as she's getting closer to dying, a lot of times it's because they don't know what to do with this person who they used to be able to go shopping with or play hockey with. And so it's about really giving them ideas of what they can now do with that person. One activity we do a lot is a hug. And so it's basically just tracing the child's arms onto a sheet or a strip of a blanket and having them decorate that. And then that can stay with the person while they're in the hospital or at the home. And it's a way a child can feel like they're able to keep some of their emotions with the person, even if they can't physically be there. Really helpful activities are anything that can also help the children and teenagers externalize their thoughts. What we don't want is them bottling everything up and driving it underground. We want to find healthy ways for them to express the feelings that they have. And we want to help them understand that grief isn't something pathological. It doesn't mean something's broken. It doesn't mean that it's something that needs to be fixed. It's a completely natural response to having somebody who you love die.